Hey folks, this is Sharad Kumar from Citron Technologies. Thanks for making your time to watch this demo video about AWS Machine Learning Workshop, which we are conducting on December 26th and 27th. So let me make this video very short. I will suggest you to watch till end of this video to get a better clarity before you registering for this workshop. Okay. So first, this is Sharad Kumar. I'm from Citron Technologies. What is this Citron Technologies and what we do in the first hand? So Citron Technologies Private Limited is an IoT and AI company in the first hand. So we work with manufacturing industries and other automobile industries. So you might be having a question. So I might be introducing myself as a training based company. So that's not the case here. So that's what the one more advantage for the people who attend our workshops and training programs. So we work with industries. We know what is how to design AI projects, how to work with IoT projects. We know what the pains and what are the right practices that we need to do. So that's what exactly our strong point is, and so that's what exactly we want to deliver in this 2 days workshop on 26th and 27th of December. So we have an expertise on top of AWS as a cloud platform and IoT and AI. So let me quickly get into the demo. Let's talk about what is this workshop is and what are the things that we're going to do on 26th and 27th of December, okay? So the first thing that I want to clarify, so this is an online workshop. And again, I want to clarify one more thing. So this is not a webinar or a seminar. So you know what is webinar and seminar. So webinar and seminar is something that you go and attend, and at end of the day, you get nothing other than a theory. So you just go and listen to the mentor and you come back, right? That's what exactly a webinar and seminar is. So what is this workshop is, especially what exactly you might be looking for in a workshop is. So workshop is something you learn by doing the things. So that's the only difference what I will tell. So as I told, it's a complete hands-on workshop. So in this 2 days on 26th and 27th of December, so you will be working on a multiple tiny projects along with me in this workshop. So whatever I do on my screen, you will be also replicating on your screen. So that's how we do on hands-on exercises. So one more thing, so this workshop is on machine learning and on top of AWS. I hope you might be heard about what is this AWS is, right? Amazon Web Services. It's a cloud platform. Obviously, you might be heard about many different cloud platforms in the world. I mean, you might be heard about Google Cloud Platform or Microsoft Azure or different types of cloud platforms which are available. So what is so much specialty on top of AWS? Why exactly you need to get started with AWS? So AWS is just a platform here for us to get started with a machine learning. And one more advantage when you're getting started with a machine learning on top of AWS is, if you see, like, AWS is a world leading cloud platform. So one great thing to tell is, so you can see, like, maximum share of a cloud is being holded by AWS comparing with any other cloud industries, what I will tell. So that's a one advantage. And you can see, like, very famous companies like Netflix completely runs on top of AWS. So there are a lot of companies uses AWS, and it's again a good start for any working professional or a student or a lecturers. So it's a good start. So now we will discuss about what is this workshop and what exactly we're going to do as part of a machine learning. Some of you guys might be new to a machine learning, and some of might have enough knowledge on machine learning. First, let us get some clarity on machine learning. So what is this machine learning is, and what is exactly machine learning, first of all, right, before getting started. So theoretically, right, so as a definition, what people used to tell, so machine learning is nothing but studying about the complex mathematical models, right? So your computer is going to learn how to make a complex mathematics on top of the algorithms, maybe use different types of mathematical algorithms to calculate, and a machine at the end of the day can able to make a predictions is nothing but a futuristic predictions. So that's how the things work. So in a layman terms, okay, so that's a theoretical definition. So in a layman terms, let me explain you in a better way where you can understand, okay? So here, let's consider a machine, okay? A machine can be, let's imagine your own PC or maybe any high-end server can be also considered as a machine, right? So let's consider this is your own personal computer, so that you usually work with, right? And so this is a machine. So what we're going to teach, so that's what the machine learning is. So you're going to teach a machine, and the machine is going to learn all the data from you, right? So first of all, let me pick a use case, then only it will be better for you to understand in a clear way. So let's consider there are many different types of use cases, obviously, right? So we'll go to that use case later. Let's pick one use case. Okay, let's take a weather forecasting as one use case here. So what is this weather forecasting? So basically you're trying to predict what it may happen in next 3 weeks, right? So you're going to predict whether it's going to be raining, whether it's going to be windy, or whether it's going to be sunny. So that's what exactly a prediction is. What may happen in the future? That's what exactly a machine learning is. That's what exactly a machine can able to predict. So first, in order to predict predict the weather, you need to have a weather data, correct? So let's imagine you may have some 3 years of weather data. Okay, let's imagine you have a weather data on your own PC. Let's imagine you have all the 3 years of weather data as a as a CSV file. Okay, so let's consider in .csv file you have all the weather data. Let's imagine you have so 3 years of weather data in your ready with you, right? So what exactly is here the deal is basically you're teaching all this data to your PC, I mean your machine or maybe any high-end server basically. So what happens, all this 3 years data will be learned by this particular machine by using a complex mathematical models. So then once it has learned everything, so then it can able to make a prediction. So the predictions is nothing but what it may happen in a, what can happen in a future. That's what the predictions are basically, right? Once if machine has learned everything from that data, it can able to make a prediction saying that, okay, the next 3 weeks would be a cloudy or next 3 weeks would be rainy. So that's what exactly a machine learning can able to do, right? Otherwise, you can take a one more use case. Let's imagine, let's imagine a energy data forecasting. I mean, energy bills forecasting. Right now, we are in a home, right? Everyone is working from a home and paying more amount of the electricity bill comparing to before COVID. During the COVID, we pay a lot of electricity bills, obviously, correct? So let's imagine you may have 3 years of your energy data. I mean, what is the amount of energy your washing machine, fridge, water geyser consumes, right? You have huge amount of data, and again in a similar fashion this machine has learned all the data, all the 3 years of electricity data, and so it can able to make a prediction saying what would be your energy bill forecast in the next upcoming 3 weeks or next upcoming year, for example. So this is the amazing use case. This is one of the use case which is a lot of startups are working as of right now, and they are adding a value to the people's, right? So this is what exactly a machine learning is. So here all I'm talking about the data, a structural data. Let's imagine you the machine learning, there are various type of use cases like face recognition, what people used to call our object and scene detection, right? So we will discuss in detail, right? So here is the first, let me clarify you guys timings, when this workshop is started, what is the timing, all the stuff. So this is how the timing is. So 26th and 27th December, we will be having this workshop. And 26th of December, so that is Saturday, we'll be having a session from 10 a.m. to 1 p.m. So on Saturday, we'll be just having half a day session. And when it comes to 27th of December, let's imagine, okay. On 27th of December, we'll be having a session from 10 a.m. to 4 p.m. That is almost a full day. So on 27th of December, we'll be having a full day session basically. So this is how the timings are. So now let me quickly get into the highlights of the workshop. So what are the things that we will be learning from this workshop, right? So fundamentals of ML and AI. We are going to start from a fundamentals as a fundamental represent. This is the workshop for the beginners. So who want to get started with a machine learning? Otherwise, who want to get started with a machine learning on top of AWS? Who want to get started from a scratch usually? So we'll be starting from a basics. We'll be, so that's the fundamentals of ML and AI. So then we will be talking about data pre-processing. What is this data pre-processing is nothing but how do you handle this particular data. So how to pre-process the data, how to filter it, how to clean the data. There are different terms what we will be using. So pre-processing is the one of the basic that we will be getting started. And then we'll be using a Python as a programming language in this workshop. Yes. So and again, one more prerequisite is if you ask, okay, do you need to be an expert in a Python to attend this workshop? My answer is no. If you have any basics in any programming language, let's imagine if you may be having some basics on C, C++, Java, or JavaScript, whatever it is, you are very most welcome to attend this workshop. So Python is a one programming language that we can get started, because people use a lot of different types of programming languages. People use Python, people use R, people use Go, right? But when it comes to Python is a great language when it comes to machine learning. So most amount of the workloads in the world is running on top of Python for machine learning. That would be the good start for you, what I will tell. So we'll be using a Python as a programming language. So as this is a workshop as part of a machine learning on top of AWS, so we'll be taking a look of the complete machine learning stack, what AWS is offering for us. So let me give a quick look of AWS console. So we once after registering for this workshop, you will be creating a AWS free trial account. We will be assisting you in that. You don't want to worry about that. So you will be creating a AWS free trial account. So once you create a AWS free trial account, So you can log in and you can check it out. So you can see this complete machine learning stack that I'm going to select right now. So we're going to take a look of all this machine learning stack that I'm marking as of right now. So you can see what AWS can able to offer you in terms of machine learning. So this is the complete services what AWS is offering. So we're going to take an introduction of every services over here, and every service is not very much important for you when it comes to getting started with machine learning actually. So we're going to discuss about the main hardcore services, what world uses, basically what is the services usually corporate uses, what are the services which is necessary for you. So those are the only services that we're going to take a look. So here, as I told, so the first service that we're going to explore, it's called Amazon Recognition. So the first service that we're going to do hands-on in this workshop, it's called Amazon Recognition. So what is this Amazon Recognition in the first hand, right? So Amazon Recognition is a computer vision-based application. So what is this computer vision-based application again? So computer vision-based application is nothing but anything that you deal with images and videos, right? So let me tell some few use cases, okay? You might be heard about face recognition application, right? So that you might be having in your phone, right? So face recognition application is nothing but you can able to bring your camera towards your phone. It can able to unlock your phone, basically. That's a computer vision based application because it can able to unlock your phone. So before, okay, going to some other details about recognition, I want you guys to realize one thing. So saying that, okay, we are in the age of ML and AI, okay? So a lot of people usually think, okay, the machine learning is a futuristic technology which is going to happen in next 5 to 10 years. So that's not the scenario here. So we are already in the age of ML and AI. So we are also already using a machine learning services. So you can be proud of using a machine learning services, but don't be so much proud, because you are watching this particular video because you want to become a machine learning engineer. You want to do something on a machine learning as a developer, correct? You want to make some innovations out of it. So then, do you know how to perform a machine learning? Do you know how to create a machine learning model? That's what exactly you are interested in. That's what exactly I want to deliver for you guys in this today's workshop, what I will tell. So for example, one example, as I told, like computer vision based application that we are already using in our phones, that is face unlocking system. And you might be using Google, right? OK Google. So you can able to use OK Google on your phone. You can able to tell go, okay Google, can you book me an alarm around 7 p.m. today, or can you able to call me my friend, right? So you can able to see that is again a one more machine learning service that we are using. And you can see Alexa, you might be heard about, right? Siri in Apple iOS operating systems, you heard about, right? So we are currently in a age of ML and AI. So it's a really time for you guys to get started with a machine learning. Otherwise, if you get started, let's imagine after 1 year or 2 year, there will be a lot of players already, so we'll be have a lot of competition for you. So better you can get started now. So let's come back to recognition. As I told, Amazon Recognition is the computer vision based application. So you can do anything related to images and video. As I told, let me provide a quick demo on recognition after done with this explanation. So you can do face recognition, object and scene detection. You can extract a text from an image, all those services. And so the next service that we're going to discuss in this workshop, it is called Amazon S3 or other databases services. So Amazon S3 is a storage platform. So why you need storage platform basically for this workshop, right? So where do you store all this data? So I'm talking about you need to store this CSV file somewhere, right? So you need to use some databases or some kind of storage platform. So we're going to discuss about Amazon S3, which is very famously used for machine learning basically. So we're going to do a lot of do's and don'ts discussions, lot of things like industrial practices. So once we are done with S3, the next platform that we're going to explore, it's called Amazon Forecast. So what is this Amazon Forecast? So as the name represents, is the forecasting platform. So you can able to do weather forecasting and let's imagine, so this energy data forecasting as we discuss right now, are more than that, right? So you can able to do, just imagine you can able to build a stock market prediction. You can able to forecast what would be the stock market predictions basically, right? So those type of applications can be done by Amazon Forecast as a service. So saying that, the next thing, right? So the very important service that we're going to discuss in this entire workshop on 26 and 27 December is called Amazon SageMaker. It's a very important service when it comes to developers. So why it is so much important is nothing but you can able to build, train and deploy. You can do these three things. It's called B, T&D. So it is called build, train and deploy. So you can able to build, train and deploy any machine learning model from a scratch. I mean, so why it is so much important is nothing but starting from a development and starting into a deployment, it can able to help you guys. So SageMaker is the real-time service that you can use for doing end-to-end machine learning development, what I will tell. So what is this B, T, and D is especially? Build is nothing but building a machine learning environment, T for training the machine learning model or training a machine, and D for deployment, deploying our machine learning model in a production-based application. So that's what exactly you might be interested in. So I will tell you one small difference, okay? So most of the people who have got started from machine learning, right? So they know how to build and train, but they never know how to deploy the model in a production-based application. In case if you are that guy, so just attend this workshop, you will be completely knowing how to deploy a machine learning model in a production-based application, actually. Yeah. So yeah, so that's what exactly Amazon SageMaker can able to help you guys in that. So yeah, especially we're going to use Amazon SageMaker service, and we're going to build a real-time project in this workshop. So we're going to use TensorFlow as an algorithm in this workshop. So you might be heard about TensorFlow. TensorFlow is a very famous algorithm. It's a world-leading algorithm. There are many different types of algorithm, again, like MXNet, PyTorch, all those stuff. But we're going to get started with a TensorFlow, which is maintained by Google. But even if it is maintained by Google, most amount of the workloads on TensorFlow is running on AWS. So we're going to build a real-time project by using TensorFlow. We discussed about energy forecasting, weather forecasting, or maybe any other examples we're going to work on by using a SageMaker, actually. So this is SageMaker is the one service that you might be looking for, actually, as a developer. So I will share this PDF in a video link. You can able to download and you can take a decisions accordingly. So if you scroll down, you will find this clear more details about the workshop curriculum. So you can get the clear details, like starting from introduction, what we're going to see in a basics, like type of machine learning. We're going to discuss about statistics and probability, which is very much basic for machine learning, data engineering, as I told, like how to handle the data analysis, how to visualize the data. And we're going to talk about a deep learning, right? So when it comes to deep learning, you might be heard about something called neural networks, what people used to call, right? So neural networks, you might be seeing this particular pictures in an internet or somewhere. It looks like circle. So what is this deep learning? Is nothing but it's a concept which is derived from our human brains, basically. So you know one thing, like in a human brain we have a neurons which carries the information from one part of a brain to another part of a brain, right? So that's what exactly neurons can do. So that's the same concept what human beings have just copied and pasted in the machine learning. So that's how the deep learning works, basically. So we're going to use deep learning algorithm. As I told, TensorFlow is a deep learning algorithm. We're going to discuss and do an answer on that. And if you scroll down, you can check it out what we're going to do by using recognition. We're going to perform all these use cases. Remember one thing, star represents a use case here in the course curriculum. We're going to explore on image moderation, facial analysis, as I told, text and image. All those use cases we'll be performing as a hands-on practical experience. So, and then we're going to discuss about Amazon S3, as I told, a storage platform in completely. Then we're going to discuss about Amazon Forecast, as I told, a forecasting platform by doing a use case. And finally, Amazon SageMaker is the one service that you might be looking for. So we're going to develop an end-to-end application by using a TensorFlow as an algorithm. And we're going to do these three things, build, train, and deploy. And we go after deployment, how your user is basically going to interact with that machine learning model. That's what exactly you might be interested in, how the final state of machine learning will look in a production based application. So these are the course curriculum details what I will tell. And what is the main prerequisites to attend this workshop? I clarified already, you don't need much programming experience. You can, if you have a very much basics on any programming language, you can very much welcome to attend this workshop. So after registration, we will help you guys to install all the necessary softwares, all the stuff. You don't have to worry about that one. So what is the main three takeaways from this workshop for you, right? So that's the one thing so that I want to tell. So the main takeaway is you will be getting started with a machine learning from a scratch and artificial intelligence. You will be getting a complete basics of what is machine learning is and what is AI is and what you can do with that, basically, right? So that's a one thing. And the second thing is you are not only getting started with machine learning, you're also getting started with AWS. You're coming to know how to use AWS and how to utilize a machine learning services on top of AWS. That's the second thing. And the third thing which you want to know, it's about our community. So what I mean by community is nothing but, so we are doing this workshop almost for 2 years and discourses for 2 years. So every person who attend our workshop and trainings, they will be added into our community groups basically. So because we are trying to bring a developers, working professional students together, so where we can able to do a lot of activities like sharing useful resources to ML and AI, or events related to ML and AI, hackathons, job opportunities, internship opportunities for students. We do a lot of stuff here. This is what exactly we are doing with the community. Basically, it will add a more value actually. And so, okay, everything is okay. Do we have any charges for this workshop? Is that a paid workshop or is that a free workshop? So it is not actually a free workshop. It's actually a paid workshop because it is not a webinar or a seminar. It's a workshop where we provide you some hands-on experience, saying that we have some minimal price on it. So AWS is supporting us in this workshop. So this is how the pricing is. So we have 2 types of tickets as of right now. One is an individual ticket. So in case if you're coming as an individual, you can just pay 1,499 rupees per person. With that, you'll be getting an entire 2 days access to the workshop. So this is the first type of ticket, and we have a second ticket that is a group ticket. So the group ticket is actually for a group of 3 people. Let's imagine, in case if you want to attend with your friends, let's imagine if you want to bring your working colleagues or friends, so you can book a group of 3 people's tickets. You will getting a the good opportunities on top of a group ticket. So you'll be getting a 10% discount for each and every person. And here is the deal. This is not the only thing. We are actually giving away the 1,750 rupees AWS credits for free. So what is this AWS credits? What you can do with that credits basically, right? So with this AWS credits, you'll be getting a 1 year free access to complete AWS cloud. So I'm not only talking about machine learning here, guys, like I'm talking about the complete AWS services. You can able to see this, the complete IT services, right? So all these things that I'm scrolling right now, right? You can able to use this complete AWS for free for next 1 year with that credits. So you can able to see by booking a group ticket, we are actually paying back almost like 60% of your money back. At the end of the day, you pay nothing actually. So this is the 2 types of tickets that we have as of right now for this ticket. And we are not doing this workshop for more than 25 people. We are just doing this workshop for less than 25 people. We are almost sold our 70% of seats. Don't lose this opportunity. We won't do this workshop again and again. So this will be a great opportunity for you guys to get started with the machine learning, obviously. As an industrial perspective, we're going to teach everything. Saying this, now quickly let me go to AWS and let me show you guys a quick demo that you can understand what exactly that we're going to do. So first, let me go to Amazon Recognition. So Amazon Recognition, I can able to give a quick demo here. So during our workshop, we're going to experiment Amazon Recognition programmatically, not via how I show a demo right now. So this demo is just to understand what you can do with Amazon Recognition, right? So these are the services what Amazon Recognition can able to do. So all the services that we're going to discuss in by doing hands-on during our workshop. So first thing that we're going to take a look, it's called object and scene detection. So what is this object and scene detection in the first time, right? So let's imagine, okay, you are going early in the morning, you're going to a park and you're taking a beautiful picture of a park, right? So what you can able to see in that picture, right? So you can able to see trees and a lot of grass, people are jogging, and you can see some dogs are walking, right? So you can able to identify, you can grab a lot of information in that, right? That is nothing but object and scene detection. It's like what exactly a machine can able to do with that. A machine can able to grab a lot of objects and scenes from it. So you can able to see a picture which is uploaded by AWS, a default picture from AWS itself. So now the predictions has been made already for this particular picture. So if I move my cursor, you can able to see the machine learning predictions. A machine can able to predict a car. You can able to see a bounding boxes on top of it. So I can able to select any object here. You can see car, and I can see a lot of cars here. You can see it can able to identify a wheel which is far more distance in that particular picture, right? So you can see a wheel. So this is what exactly machine learning is. A machine can able to identify objects and scenes. If I move my cursor near to this person, you can see it can able to identify it as a person. And if I move my cursor near to that skateboard, it can able to identify a skateboard. So you can see this is what machine learning can able to do. And towards right side, you can able to see the percentage. You can see automobiles 98.8%. It means nothing but a machine is sure. Its machine is telling 98.8%. I'm sure there are automobiles, there are vehicles, there are cars, there is a transportation. You can hit show more. we'll get some more details, right? That so let me upload my picture from my own PC. Now we'll try to understand. Let's see. Now I'm going to upload a picture that I have taken during our offline classes that we conduct during in our Bangalore. So that is before COVID, not now. So you can see quickly after uploading this photo, it has made a lot of predictions. You can see it tells it's a desk. Yes, it's a desk. It's a laptop. And again, you can see there's a person. You can see there's a one person here. That's actually me. Person. You can see this is what object and scene detection is. So let me go to one more service, that is facial analysis. That is nothing but a face detection system that you have on your mobile phone already. So here you can see a beautiful woman, okay, which is she is driving a car, right? So this is nothing but a face detection application that you have already in your mobile phone, which will help you to unlock your faces actually. So here you can see a woman. So, and let me see the predictions towards the right side. So it tells looks like a face, 99.9% it's a face and appears to be female. You can see a machine can able to identify a gender difference. Okay, appears to be female, 99.3%, and looks age range 21 to 30 years old, right? Just check out the age, right? It actually makes sense, 21 to 33 years old, and looks like smiling, appears to be happy, wearing sunglasses, eyes are open, does not have a mustache. Obviously she doesn't have any mustache, and see the prediction results, 99.8% machine is sure she doesn't have a mustache. Yes, right? So I can pick one more image here. So that is a family picture. You can see a daughter, father and mother. I can pick any photo I want. Let me pick a daughter and let me see the predictions. Looks like a face, 99.9%, appears to be female, 99.2%, makes sense. Check out the age range, right? So 5 to 15 years old. Yes, obviously that kid is exactly 5 to 15 years old. She is not more than that, right? So this is what exactly a face analysis. We're going to also explore these use cases by doing programmatically during our workshop. So make sure you register. Don't lose this opportunity. So the next service that we're going to take a look, it's called text in an image. Basically, it's nothing but it can able to extract every text from an image basically. So here you can see this particular car, and I can able to see my number plate, which has been extracted. I can able to see the number plate. So you can see this is the text and image. Just imagine the number of use cases that you can build upon this one, right? And let me tell the use cases, okay? So what companies uses by using Amazon recognition. So a lot of event companies, medical companies, there's a lot of medical use cases on top of Amazon recognition, on top of SageMaker, what I will tell. So and US government is using this service. If you know, like Amazon recognition is being used by US government. So do you know what they do, right? They use this one, a face recognition application. So if we watch all the Hollywood movies, Bollywood movies, right, exactly like that. So you can able to see a terrorist who is caught in a camera, they used to run a face recognition application to match the face. That is the exact application US police department, they are using in a real time as of right now. Be safe when you're going to US, right? You would be also getting into that face recognition application. Yeah. And the last thing that I want to show you guys in a demo, it's called PPE detection. AWS has developed this one during a COVID situation. It can able to identify all the PPEs. Here you can see a four guys who are standing in an industry. I can pick any person. You can see it can able to identify head cover, face cover, that is a face mask. Okay. So this is all about Amazon recognition. So this is what exactly what we're going to build. So I cannot give a demo on Amazon SageMaker because we need to do a lot of work. That's what exactly we're going to do in this workshop basically. So this is all about our workshop. So you can register as soon as possible. Don't miss this opportunity. So yeah, you can grab a lot of information from this workshop. You can also check out this PDF. You can check out this frequently asked questions at the bottom side. So recordings will be provided. You will be having recordings for next 1 week after the workshop. Certificates will be provided. Yes, that is mandatory. And in case if you are a student, you will be having an opportunity to apply for an internship with us, because we are a product-based company. You can also work with us. So yeah, in case if you got selected, that would be a great opportunity for you to work with us. And you can also check out the feedbacks from our previous customers. So our participant, what they are talking about our workshop, they have attended our ML workshop, our IoT workshops. So take a look. So don't miss this opportunity. Very limited seats what we have. So if you miss this opportunity, you will not get it. Once again, I cannot guarantee it. So make sure you register for it. So at end of, now, let me give a one more short demo, and you can So we'll be done with that. So I'm going to give a one more demo on one more platform called Amazon Lex. What is this Amazon Lex? Is nothing but Amazon Lex is the chatbot platform. You know, one more thing, like chatbots are ruling the world as of right now, mostly into digital marketing. So you can see a lot of chatbots on a Flipkart. You can see Amazon as a flat chatbot, and a lot of digital marketings is being triggered by and adding a more benefits to digital marketing via chatbots actually. So here I have developed the chatbot basically for a flower shop, the guy who is selling a flowers. Basically this chatbot is actually developed, I mean Amazon Lex is actually derived from Amazon Alexa. You know that Amazon Alexa, right? So in this chatbot, I can able to interact with the text and audio. So let me interact with this chatbot. Let me interact with an audio first. Let's see what is the response. I would like to order some flowers.
I didn't understand you. What would you like to do?
Again. I would like to order some flowers.
What type of flowers would you like to order?
So you might be heard the response. You can see when I interact with the audio, you will get audio as a response. But now let me interact with the voice. So let me tell roses. So what day do you want roses to be picked up? So now there is no audio because I'm interacting with the text. Let me tell. So 2020-12-70, that is tomorrow. So what time tomorrow? So I can mention 10 a.m. So the roses is ready to pick up on tomorrow around 10 a.m. will cost $25. Oh my God, $25. It's more than our workshop cost, but our workshop is more affordable. Don't miss it. Go and grab the seats. Does it sound okay? Yes.
Okay.
Thanks. Your order for roses has been placed and will be ready for pickup by 10 o'clock on December 17th, 2020.
That's amazing, guys. So this is all about a quick demo. So make sure you grab the seats. If you miss the opportunity, I cannot guarantee you may get in the same price next time. So this is going to be a complete hands-on workshop. Hope we will meet during our workshop on 27th and 26th of December, basically Saturday and Sunday, 26th and 27th of December. Thanks for attending. Thanks for making your time to watch this video. Then thank you. Bye.